My name is Serafim Stakidis. I'm representing AIDEAS, and I'm going to present the MLID component. In this presentation, I will highlight all the efforts we made to develop the MLID component. I will also present all the achievements in the first implementation phase. Conclusions and next steps will be also provided. At the end of the presentation, a short demo will be given. So, first of all, a few words about the scope. The main objectives are to identify hidden patterns and finally classify traffic generated from honeypot interactions. The implementation was divided into two phases. The first is exploratory, with an objective to try out different methodologies and designs in order to select the optimum. And the second phase starts at month 22, will last until month 30, and will focus on fine-tuning improvements and integration with the rest of the component. First of all, we designed, implemented, and validated a standard machine learning pipeline that involves data handling, data normalization, feature selection, classification, and finally validation using a public benchmark data set. And I will present the results later on in my presentation. The second approach is based on deep learning and is actually a novel pipeline. It consists of various processing steps. One of the novelties is actually that a modality transformation is performed to convert the feature vectors into images that are more interpretable. So, once the feature vector has been converted to an image, then we apply CNN for dimensionality reduction. So we convert the image to a single number feature that could be considered as a risk factor that quantifies the behavior of a user or an attacker. And we finally apply ML to provide the final decision. We finally implemented an unsupervised approach, employing autoencoders, similarly to approach A, with an exception of using autoencoders instead of machine learning models. Here we show some of our results. Approach B outperforms the other two approaches on average, whereas the variant of approach B, employing Adabus as a classifier, gave the best overall performance. So adopting the best performing approach, we then conducted an extensive comparison with 12 competing state-of-the-art algorithms. The best detection performance was achieved by the proposed methodology and only using one extracted feature that is quite impressive, and the rest of the algorithms gave moderate to bad results. So to conclude, best results were achieved by approach B, and that was the one selected. Moderate results by approach A and C, and say, the rest of the competing state-of-the-art algorithms. We need to stress out that the time required to convert a record with raw data from the honeypot to a final decision is less than 0.1 seconds, that makes possible the real-time or semi-real-time application of the component. Overall, phase one was completed, the associated deliverable was successfully submitted, and we also submitted a journal paper to Springer Cybersecurity that is actually accepted for publication and will be available soon online. Next steps include the integration of the MLID component with the rest of the components and retraining of the methodology using data from the honeypot and identify different attacks. That is a task in progress. In the last part of my presentation, I have a short demo that demonstrates how the MLID component works. So let's consider that we have two data streams coming from the honeypot. One is representing normal user, the green one, and the other attacks, the orange one. Checking the raw data is almost impossible to extract any knowledge. The MLID component performs modality transformation, so it transforms raw data to image in which visual patterns can be identified. Then the images are transformed to a single feature indicator. The green data stream receives values around 0.5, in our case, where the orange one, the attacker's one, receives much lower values. The MLID component needs approximately 0.06 seconds average response time per feature to provide a decision that is then sent to the rest of the components. And this is the end of my presentation. I'm very happy to listen to any questions. Thank you very much.